battle cry will be total extermination.
They are to be exterminated.
Exterminate, annihilate, destroy. Daleks conquer and destroy.
Exterminate them.
The Daleks shall sweep away Gallifrey.
You not deviate.
Exterminate.
The finale of Series 1 / Season 27, Bad Wolf and the Parting of the Ways, is technically a two-parter, but the plot started 5 episodes earlier in The Long Game, where the Ninth Doctor and Rose, with zero help from Adam Mitchell, managed to dismantle the systems upholding Satellite 5 in the year 200,000, which was broadcasting fake news and mass entertainment to the people of Earth. While that story does lead into this two-parter, I will not be reviewing The Long Game, mainly because it doesn't have the Daleks in it at all, but because I've watched around 85 episodes of Doctor Who over the past 15 days, and my brain might not be able to handle much more of this. I hope you folks are spending time with family this Christmas, because I'm spending today alone and crying because I watched my first Doctor regenerate and I'm not handling it well. Bad Wolf opens with the Ninth Doctor waking up in a futuristic version of the Big Brother house, Rose being forced to play a deadly game of the Weakest Link game show, and new companion Captain Jack Harkness suffering the indignity of what not to wear.
We're giving you a brand new image.
Oh, hold on, I was with the Doctor. Why, is there something wrong with what I'm wearing?
The Doctor and Jack manage to escape their respective shows, but fail to save Rose from being disintegrated by the android, which is the greatest pun in the show's history. In an effort to find out who is in charge of the game station, which is a converted Satellite 5, the Doctor and Jack discover that while Rose is still alive, she has been transported to a nearby Dalek fleet. Survivors from the Time War and led by the Dalek Emperor, they've been slowly building a new Dalek army with the losers of the game shows. It's up to our heroes to stop the impending Dalek invasion, which could put the entire universe at risk of Dalek conquest. Now, much like Dalek, I've already done in-depth reviews of these stories in the past, so I won't go into nearly as much detail here, and I'll mainly be focusing on the Parting of the Ways because that's where most of the Dalek action is. However, I'd be remiss to mention that I tend to go back and forth as to whether or not the game show elements of Bad Wolf ages this episode. I think over the past 15 years, it's gone in cycles. Depending on what's on TV now, it's dated, but in some years, the Big Brother and reality TV elements are incredibly relevant. But the main theme that was instigated in The Long Game and further emphasized in Bad Wolf is humanity's addiction to increasingly extreme reality television, and that element feels more relevant as time goes on.
The human race, brainless sheep, being fed on a diet of... Mind you, have they still got that program where three people have to live with a bear?
Not to immediately date this episode, but in 2019, The Jeremy Kyle Show was taken off the air after one guest committed suicide after filming his appearance, and Love Island, which also has an after-broadcast body count, will be filming 2 seasons in 2020. To quote the Doctor when he's told that there are 60 Big Brother houses going on at the same time...
It's a charnel house!
The android is still a terrific villain. Captain Jack is a lot of fun with his fashion show, and the design of the robots does feel timeless and also a great piece of foreshadowing, as they were likely created by the Daleks. As for the other Bad Wolf stuff, Linda with a Y is a lovely supporting character, and because this is a Dalek story, she's down for certain death, but we'll get to that later. When Rose wakes up on the Dalek ship, the POV shot from the Dalek's perspective is a homage to their first appearance back in 1963. The Doctor's silent fury after seeing Rose get seemingly killed in front of him is also chilling stuff, leading to one of the greatest cliffhangers in the show's entire history, and I don't say that lightly.
We have your associate! She will be exterminated!
No.
Explain yourself!
I said no.
What is the meaning of this negative?
It means no.
But she will be destroyed!
No! Because this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna rescue her. I'm gonna save Rose Tyler from the middle of the Dalek fleet, and then I'm gonna save the Earth, and then, just to finish off, I'm gonna wipe every last stinking Dalek out of the sky!
But you have no weapons, no defenses, no
there. And doesn't that scare you to death?
This is not a cliffhanger for Rose. This is not a cliffhanger for the Doctor. This is a cliffhanger for the Daleks. We don't know how the Doctor is going to save Rose with the odds stacked against him so much, but he promised that he would, so we know he's going to do it. And that ambiguity causes the Daleks to flip out and begin their invasion.
Rose?
Yes, Doctor?
I'm coming to get you.
The Doctor is initiating hostile action!
Bastard, at your must advance! Begin the invasion of Earth!
The Doctor will be exterminated!
Real talk here, Bad Wolf and the Parting of the Ways was broadcast around my 13th birthday. Me and my friends made an event of watching the Parting of the Ways. We sat down in my living room, popcorn and snacks were made, and that weekend changed my life. The Parting of the Ways is a wonderful story. Firstly, it's relentless in its pace. Every scene has purpose, and there's not a wasted line. The reveal of the Dalek Emperor is beautifully staged, as is the reveal that the Daleks have been driven insane by their very means of creation.
Driven mad by your own flesh. The stink of humanity. You hate your own existence. And that makes them more deadly than ever.
The Doctor may come on board the Dalek ship with bravado, calling himself the oncoming storm and showing the Daleks who's boss.
You might have removed all your emotions, but I reckon right down deep in your DNA there's one little spark left. And that's fear. Doesn't it just burn when you face me?
And I tell you what, I hope nature takes its revenge on you, every single one of you, that leaves shit on the floor and in parks. And I hope the planet turns round and shits on you.
And coming across as holding all of the leverage, but in one of the most impactful shots of the story, the Doctor inside the TARDIS just rests his head on the door, distraught and seemingly already admitting defeat as the cries of his most feared enemy echo on the other side. The Doctor's plan involves making a Delta Wave, using the game station's resources which would wipe out both the Earth and the Dalek fleet, and in order to buy him time to make it, the former con man who would run away from his issues, Captain Jack, rallies whatever troops he can to mount a desperate, last-ditch offensive. However, the 100 people who remain on the bottom floor of the station, who don't believe the Daleks exist, well, this is one of the show's darkest moments.
Floor Zero. They killed them all.
The Daleks didn't have to do that. Their objective is on the top floor, but they made a concerted effort and went out of their way to kill them because they weren't Dalek. But the soldiers upstairs don't fare much better. They're barely able to slow down the Daleks, but they do it anyway to help the Doctor. Except for Rose, who the Doctor tricks into entering the TARDIS and sends her back home, leaving a pre-programmed voice message instructing her on what's happening.
This is Emergency Program 1. Rose, now listen. This is important. If this message is activated, then it can only mean one thing. We must be in danger, and I mean fatal. I'm dead or about to die any second with no chance of escape.
No.
And that's okay. Hope it's a good death. But I promise to look after you, and that's what I'm doing. The TARDIS is taking you home. And if you want to remember me, then you can do one thing. That's all. One thing.
Have a good life. Do that for me, Rose. Have a fantastic life.
Oh boy. Come on, Will. Come on, you can do it. I'm not even acting up here. I genuinely had to try and stop myself from crying when I watched this scene again. Once Rose is back home with her mum Jackie and boyfriend Mickey, she then lays out the point of Doctor Who Series 1.
The Doctor showed me a better way of living your life. You know he showed you too. That you don't just give up. You don't just let things happen. You make a stand. You say no. You have the guts to do what's right when everyone else just runs away and I can't.
Go back and watch my in-depth review of The Parting of the Ways for more clarity, but basically, in Series 1, the Doctor didn't actually do that much, at least when you look at his direct actions on the plot. But what he did do was be an instigator for change just by inspiring the people around him to be better, to fight back. For the first time in Dalekcember, we're dealing with serialized theming over the course of several stories, all culminating in this go-for-broke finale. Series 2 was not a sure thing at this point. This could have been the only series that Russell T. Davis & Co. could have gotten, which means that all of the cards are on the table here, including a fully realised arc for the Doctor. To date, Eccleston's Doctor might be the only one who has a coherent character arc from beginning to end, where he's given the option to wipe out another race at the same time as the Daleks. But he's a changed man since the Time War, and he can't do it again.
I want to see you become like me. Hail the Doctor, the Great Exterminator!
I'll do it!
Then prove yourself, Doctor! What are you, coward or killer?
Coward. Any day.
Speaking of this scene, we have a brand new Dalek Emperor, making a reappearance after almost 40 years after Evil of the Daleks, and unlike that version where he just stood there looking impressive, this one actually has more of a personality. With a serious god complex, it even tries to argue philosophy with the Ninth Doctor. The design is also terrific as well, and Nicholas Briggs' vocal performance is intimidating and spot on.
Purify the earth with fire. The planet will become my temple and we shall rise. This will be our paradise.
While the Daleks might not have as much character as the Metaltron in the last story, they're still an intimidating presence. They're downright scary. Not to mention cultish, as they have a fanatical devotion to their Emperor.
That makes them half human.
Those words are blasphemy! Do not blaspheme! I reached into the dirt and made new life. I am the god of all Daleks!
And I bring you
fire!
I'll take you to burn!
They're insane!
Joe Ahern uses lighting and creative angles to really get across the menace of these war machines. One of the best scenes is the death of Linda, who is on the observation deck, only for the Daleks to discover her. Cornered as the Daleks are cutting through the door, the Daleks also emerge from outside the window, and with a silent exterminate, blast her into the vacuum of space. Incidentally, in my interview with Joe Ahern in the Dalek video, he names this as his favourite death in his episodes. Please check out that video, as YouTube's algorithms buried it. Anyway, Rose looks into the heart of the TARDIS and manages to get back to the game station in the future to save the Doctor, who has accepted his fate and awaits extermination. She uses the time vortex to destroy the Daleks, but the power is killing her. So the Doctor, through a kiss, takes the energy for himself, which will destroy his body and prompt a new regeneration. Yeah, Rose appearing is a bit of a Deus Ex Machina ending, however, it does fit thematically with what Series 1 has been going for, and the godlike power she's given does have an in-universe consequence. So it does work here, resulting in one of my favourite regeneration scenes where the Doctor is trying to explain it to Rose, and make things easy for her.
Time Lords have this little trick, it's sort of a way of cheating death. Except it means I'm going to change. And I'm not going to see you again. Not like this. Not with this daft old face.
And the best part is, he goes out with a smile. That's the most important part here. This is not a time for mourning. This is not a time for being sad. The Doctor is going to change, and he's okay with it. He has to be, for Rose's sake. But the Doctor, having now accepted who he is after the events of the Time War, the coward, not the killer, the healer, not the harvester, a doctor to the people who helped him through his grief, the Ninth Doctor's arc comes to an end with a beaming smile and a fiery rebirth.
And before I go...
Don't say that.
Rose. Before I go, I just want to tell you, you were fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. And you know what? So was I.
The context of Dalekcember, Bad Wolf and the Parting of the Ways is an odd story to talk about, because while they're not the focus of the story despite being the primary threat, the Daleks are the main catalyst for change in the Ninth Doctor's season-long story arc. Like I said, go and watch my in-depth review for more detail and more opinions, but this story still stands as one of my all-time favourites. Every time I watch it, I flash back to me having just celebrated my 13th birthday watching my Doctor fight his final battle. Seeing the series that made me want to work in the media industry, and knowing that even 14 to 15 years later, I am now working in that industry, that this story still holds up, is still scary, is still heart-wrenching, and is still funny as hell.
Identify yourself!
You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
Yes!
And now, with a new Doctor comes more Dalek adventures, with David Tennant as the 10th Doctor. Join me tomorrow on Dalekcember, where the rivalry, 40 years in the making, will finally come to a head. See you folks then.